this is the most simple instruction or most simple one of the most simple assembly language program of microcontroller, that is addition of two 8-bit data. That means where we are going with the two operand, both are 8-bit. Okay, so now let the two data are, one is 0 to 8 and another one is the 0 to 5 8. We have to add these two data. So first we have to store this value to accumulator and this value to size accumulator. The registers which are performed in any type of instruction we can use here, like B or any R0 to R7 registers are used, may be used here. Okay, so first of all, the ASL is first move A hash 0 to 8, that means load the data 0 to 8 to accumulator immediately. Okay, next, again move B hash 0 to 5 8. So here load the data that is given, or you can assume that 0 to 5 8 to register B immediately. Okay, now that is add A B, then is done. This is addition and this is the program. So here mark is the 7 level. So one thing is that this accumulator is mainly perform the any type of arithmetical and logical operation. So we have to involve this accumulator each and every type of performance. One data must be stored in accumulator. So in that case, we have to use the accumulator, and one data had to be stored in accumulator, another data may be stored in another register. If you are going to store this data to another register, so first you have to copy this data or load this data from that particular register to accumulator. Okay. Now coming to the subtraction of unsigned number, here we can observe this subtraction portion, this performance have the two part, either carry equals to 0 or carry equals to 1. That means we have to subtract our data from accumulator and then carry. So here the two condition can arise. One thing, carry may be 0 or carry may be 1. So here when we are going to subtract the data from the data which is stored in accumulator, the step 1, that is take the 2's complement of source operand. Next step 2, then add it to the minu end, that is which is stored in accumulator. Now step 3 is, next invert the carry. Okay, so now suppose the betas. One beta is 4CH and another beta is 6EH. So, first we are going to convert them into the binary value. What is that? In case of 4C, we get 0100 and C 1100. Now, and in case of 6E, that is 0110, 1110. Okay. So, first, as because we have to subtract this value from 4CH, that is 4C minus 6EH, like that. And what is the result? So, first, we have to make the 2's complement of this value. So, first, in case of 2's complement, we have to first convert it. That means 1's complement is happened here. First 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay. Next, we have to add 0, 1. Then, we are going with the... Okay. So, here... Now, this value have to subtract from the previous value, that is 4CH. Now, we are going to subtract 1, 0, 0, 1. Here, 0, 0, 1, 0. And we are going to subtract here. That is, we get the value. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. So, this 0 is carry. Step 3, invert the carry. Now, we have to invert this value, that means 0. If 0 is present here, so we are going to invert them and get 1. So, as because this 1, so it indicates that the result is negative value. If this is 1, hold on, if the carry is 1, okay, if or if the carry is 1 in this place, then we have to convert this 1 to 0 and this indicate that is the positive value. So now, with these two operand, we are going with the assembly language program. So first step is, this instruction is has taken place in the special case, special in programming, that is CLRC, that means clear the carry flag, because carry flag has the important role in arithmetic program and especially in the subtraction function. Okay. Next is move a hash 4CH, that means load immediately this data to accumulator. Now SUBB means subtract with borrow. A hash 6EH, that means immediately subtract with borrow this data 6EH from accumulator. Now the two condition can arise, either carry is 0 or carry is 1. So here the instruction is come JNC, that means jump not carry. Here this is marking, this is the another marking, jump not carry. If there is no carry is present, that means if CY is 0, then jump to the next target. Okay, where this next means this marking target, where here, and we are going to instruction move R1, that means the subtraction result is going to the another register or another location. Okay, but if carry equals to 1, then we have to CPL A, that means complement the value which is stored in accumulator. That means here once complement is happened, next the two's complement is happened, that means INC A. These two instruction represents the 2's complement. Okay, first one, this is only for 1's complement, and INC 1, that means addition of 0 1, or here you can also use add 0 1 or addition hash 01H, add 01H, that is on here, or INCA, that is indicating that the value, once complement value is incremented by 1. Okay. So this is the actual subtraction program. Now coming with the subtraction of 2 16 bit data. Okay. The operand are 16 bit. One thing is that the two operands, suppose here 2762 minus 1296H. We have to first perform with the MSB portion, then we have to perform with the LSB portion. So here also we are going with dividing part. This is MSB, this is LSB, this is also MSB, this is also LSB. So first we have to think, from this MSB we have to subtract this value. So 27 is greater than 12, but in case of this LSB, that is 62 is less than 96. So what we have to do now, we have to perform the 2's complement of this value and then perform the actual program. Now just see here, that is 62, we are going with the binary of the 62, 0110 0010, and 96, so we have to substitute here. Okay, now 96, we have to convert this 1001 and 60110. First we have to do the 1's complement, that is 1010110. Now we have going with the addition of this value, that means we get 0101010. Okay, so we get the 2's complement. This is the first result of the first subtraction. Okay. So now, CH. This is MSB and this is LSB. Okay. CLRC. Okay. Next, move A hash 62H. Then subtract with borrow A hash 96H. From here we get the value 68. Next one is move R7A. Value is going to store in R7. Now accumulator is blank, so move A, we can involve it in the next instruction. So move A hash 27H. Then subtract with borrow accumulator hash 12H. Okay, and here already subtraction is happened and the value is generated, that is result is generated, and this result is going to store R6A. So here we get the 14H. So if we, and now if we observe this, then we can see here that this 14 is going to store in R6 and CC is going to store to the R7 location.